Hey, good morning to every one of you. I'm your boy Mark. This is Eclipse Lawn Care. We're gonna stop here over at my convenience store and hopefully they got some good bananas to eat. And I'll probably pick me up a protein bar or a breakfast bar, whatever you want to call it. I know somebody in the comments was saying, what's so healthy about bananas and the protein bar? It's all carbs and this and that, yada, yada. Hey, it's better than the junk that I usually eat, right? But before we get there, haven't had an issue with the trailer. I think one of the tires may be low. Haven't looked at it. I heard on the way over here, I heard kind of like thud. Clankety, clank, clank, thud, thud, thud. Does that make sense? I don't know what it is. Hopefully it's not a blowout. If it is, I'm going to be kind of SOL because I don't have a spare. I need to go get the spare that I had. I think it's busted up too. So hopefully it's not a flat tire. So let's go check it out. Like I said, I heard it on this side. It's coming from here. Please don't let it be a flat. Okay, good. So I heard it on this side, not too sure what it is. So we don't have a flat. I think it's under here though. I don't know if y'all guys can see anything. I can't tell. The other side, nope. It's not coming from the other side. Definitely coming from this side though. Trust me, I heard it. I don't know what it is. I mean, it's definitely needs some air there, but I don't see what. I don't see anything on this side. That side neither. Well, let me see. I mean, I just got a brand new tire here. Hey, wait a minute. Wait a minute. Hold on a minute. I wonder if that was that making the noise? The heck is that? Oh my gosh, okay. You guys thinking what I'm thinking? Uh-oh, I think I have an idea of what this is. Let's get in here before somebody freaking thinks we're crazy out here. Hold on, let's get in here in the... Hold on a minute, what is that?
Let's... I wanted to post up because I want to be able to get this with two hands real quick because I have no idea what this is. I have an idea. I think I know what it is, but how was this making all that racket? Yep. It's a burrito, dude. What? Somebody playing a joke on me or what? 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 That is just weird. I don't know if y'all can see what's in here. Papas, chorizo, bacon. What? Nah, bro. I'm getting pong, bro. You gotta be kidding me, bro. And it's warm, too. Nah, bro, I don't know about this. Like, I don't know. Like, I don't even want to touch it, bro. Like, I really don't want to touch this. But you guys, are you thinking what I'm thinking? Take a bite out of it? Is that what you're saying? Take a bite out of it? See? Nah, bro, I can't. Dude, no. Somebody is freaking punking me, bro. And I don't see anybody, bro. I mean, look, smells good. Looks good. I don't know, you guys thinking what I'm thinking? I think we're gonna go ahead and go in for a bite. All right, guys, say a little prayer for me. Here we go. for another second bite. Bacon seems fresh, like it's just been cooked, which is crazy. Potatoes seem fresh. Chorizo has that nice flavor, that nice spicy kick. Not overwhelming, but it has a nice little kick. Good flavor, good flavor. Tortilla is so, it's tight. Seems store-bought. It's not homemade tortilla. Good. This is great. I better not eat all of it because, like I said, I still got to go in there and actually eat a protein bar. See if they got any bananas. But as far as finding this breakfast burrito on my tire, I mean, it's unbelievable. Unbelievable. I still think somebody, but how was it making that thud when I was rolling down the street though? Doesn't make sense. Unless there's somebody in the trailer and they're like kind of, I don't know, I feel like I'm getting punk, man. Is there a camera around here? Am I gonna show up on punk? You got punk? All right, well, I'm gonna continue to nibble on this, and I gotta go inside, get me some ice and maybe some bananas. Then we're gonna hit up our first lawn of the day. So guys, please stay tuned, man. Please hit that subscribe, ring that bell, and we'll see y'all on the lawn. Let's go. All right, here we go. First yard of the day. Rise and shine. How's everybody doing? Man, I'm feeling great. Had me a nice little breakfast there. So now we're gonna go ahead and knock out this yard here. I'm gonna use the Skag. Give you a little view real quick. That's it. I'm gonna use the Skag V-Ride. But the thing is, there's always trash, so we gotta pick up some trash. Just a wear glove. We gotta wear a glove, gotta stay safe, because who knows what's in that trash, you know what I mean? Let's see if I can put this glove on without a... Alright, glove fits. Oh, damn. Let's hurry up, because I think this neighbor here needs to get out of the way. Got a beer can there. I think we're good. I think that was it. Okay. Not as much trash as I thought there was going to be. But we did pick up a Modelo can. So let's go ahead and get on the Skag.
Okay, we're done here. First property of the morning. I mean, I think it looks good for what it is. I don't think they really irrigate this property, or it looks like they may not even treat the grass as well. So, but y'all guys can see behind me, we put a nice little edge to it. Nice little crisp. There you go. Backyard looks, mwah. Backyard looks spectacular, guys. I'm not gonna show it to y'all, but y'all guys just go, oh, I'm about to get run over here. All right, it looks spectacular. Y'all just gonna have to take my word for it, guys. It's probably the best one you guys ever seen. That's how good it is. That's how awesome it looks in the backyard. So let's go ahead and let's get to moving. Let's get to our next property. Let's see if we can't get all, every property that's on the list today. It's 84 degrees. I don't know how hot it's gonna be, but I can tell you it's hot. It's already hot, humid. That's Texas. All right, let's get to the next lawn quick. All right, guys, we're here at our next property. I'm gonna show you how I get down. I'm gonna post up. This is probably one of my biggest yards. Not the biggest, but one of my biggest yards. So we're definitely gonna have to use a skag on this one. No doubt about that. So there she is. We're gonna get her out and we're gonna get busy and knocking this property out right here. So far it's been a pretty good day. It's hot, but it's really not overbearing like it was the past couple of days. I'm gonna be able to knock these yards out, hopefully. I was kind of debating whether to skip this one or not. It looks like they haven't been irrigating. We got some brown patches up here in this area, and of course that is Bermuda grass. I was kind of hesitating, but no, there's some stragglers. We'll top it off, make it look nice. So we're gonna use a skag. Let's post up. Let's do it. Come on. Let's go. I'm not a real big fan of these gas cans. I bought this one over at Walmart. I don't like this safety mechanism that I have here. It's really hard. And not only that, but within like 2 weeks, the gasket, the rubber gasket that goes in here, corroded, I guess, or tore, and it does leak. So I super tighten up this here and still leaks. So it's very bad. If you guys have any suggestions on a better gas can, please let me know in the comments below, because I definitely want to get rid of this and get me something better. Let's go ahead and post up and let's do some grass cutting. let's go ahead and check out this property real quick, guys, and see what we did. We mowed, edge, trimmed the best of our ability. Sorry, that was the last spit. But check it out, check it out, check it out. It looks pretty dang good. We had to knock out about a more width on this side. This is still their property, so we went ahead and knocked this edge out. Let's take a look at the backyard real quick. So we did use a skag, as you guys can see, 32 inch cut. Maybe a bigger mower would probably be suffice for this property here, but we were able to knock that out solo, no help, not bad. So this is Bermuda grass, and I don't think the homeowners water it much, especially now in the summer. We definitely have to water. Water is key. Probably need to water it a little bit more. They do feed it. However, if you feed it and not water it, pretty much defeats the purpose. But it looks pretty nice. It looks cut. Looks better than what it did earlier. This is a weekly customer. We definitely have to schedule for shrubs, but we'll do that once we stop mowing. So the backyard, we've already seen the backyard. That's the side there. Not bad. Edges look nice and clean. Hopefully they stay that way. Not bad, not bad. Just that little bit of walking around definitely made me sweat. So I'm gonna stay in the AC for a little bit. I think I'm gonna do maybe just two more. The beast yard, the biggest yard that I have, I think I'm gonna wait till the morning to do it, the cool of the morning. It's 11:47, almost lunchtime. I don't know. I may have some CC's pizza tonight. We'll see. Y'all gotta stay tuned for the lunch segment of this. My battery's fixing to run out. I don't know. I may do one small yard a day and leave my two big ones tomorrow because they're gonna be side by side. So stay tuned. I think we're gonna have lunch right about now. All right, we're here at our last property. This is gonna be my last one for today. It's about 2:15 or so, but let's go ahead and take a look what we're working with. So this particular yard is gonna be a push mow yard. This is Bermuda grass. We usually mow it about a 3.5 using the Honda. Looks pretty thick, and it's usually as thick, and this particular customer does treat their yard. We were using the Skag on here, but the customer decided, because they always have like water, see, it's always soaked. There's always water here, and always water right here. There's always standing water here. And of course, we leave ruts and stuff with the Skag. So customer asked that we push mow, which I guess we got to do what we got to do with the push mower. So let's see, right now we have it on 3.5, but it looks like it's a little bit thick, so we may have to go, let's go with the 4. We'll push mow the front yard, then we'll go to the backyard. Which I think next year, I'm definitely gonna change my prices. If I have to push mow a yard, I'm gonna have to probably go about 33% up in charge, just because we have to push mow. So it's a little inconvenient, but it is what it is. So let's go. Come on. I don't know, kind of looks like it's not really taking much off. We're gonna have to go a notch down, so let's go from 4 to 3.5. It just seems like it's not taking barely anything off. We want to at least take a quarter off. Let's see what this does. Thank you.
we got done knocking that last yard. I'm done. It is 3:37. I know I stayed out here a little bit longer than usual. Usually 1:30 I like to kind of cut it off, but we did have a longer lunch today. It was nice to be in the AC, nice to have some hot pizza. But you know what, you know, I was able to knock this last one out, guys. I felt good. I felt great. I'm not even tired, to be honest with you. It was a hot one today, but it wasn't as hot as it was last week, last 7 days. But it was okay. It was good. I'm going to knock out two big ones tomorrow, first thing in the morning. They were on the schedule for today, but I wasn't able to get to them. Sorry, guys. I didn't give you the footage of the aftermath on this last one we did. But take my word for it, it came out super nice. It looked very nice. I wish you guys would have, y'all guys should have seen this yard the way I left it. I mean, I left it crispy. I left it luscious. The yard was on fire. No joke. But hey, guys, thank you once again for watching my videos. I am your boy, Mark B. We'll see you next time. Peace.